What are the best cell phone plans for traveling internationally? This is a question many people are wondering, but there's not a whole lot of information about. That's why I decided to sign up for Verizon, AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, and Project Fi while traveling internationally to the UK, Denmark, Sweden, and Iceland to figure out what the best options are for traveling abroad. Right up front, this is gonna be an information-packed video. Links to everything you need can be found in the video description. Here are timestamps, also linked down below, so you can jump to the exact section of the video you're looking for. And I even have a blog post up on my website covering everything I talk about in this video. Diving right in, the two main questions people are wondering are what works with my current plan and what are my other options? It turns out when you're traveling internationally, you have three main options. First option is to do nothing. Second option is to purchase an add-on for your current plan. And the third option is to sign up for a carrier and plan at the country you're visiting. Let's quickly go through each of these. The first option is simple. Simply do nothing. Toggle your phone into airplane mode to avoid any potential international data roaming charges, and you're good to go. You'll be able to use Wi-Fi at your hotel and coffee shops. And for a lot of people, this is the best option. It's the most affordable, it'll work with your phone, you're gonna save money and avoid any potential charges, and it's, you know, it just works. However, many of you may want cellular data while traveling abroad, so that brings us to the second option, and this is to purchase an international add-on for your current plan. Based on my research, most people are using Verizon, AT&T, Sprint, and T-Mobile, so I decided to sign up for all of those plans, along with Project Fi, to break down what their international offerings are. First up is Verizon. Verizon has three types of international options: travel passes, monthly international plans, and pay-as-you-go rates. Travel passes are $5 a day for Canada and Mexico, and $10 a day internationally. Your current plan carries over, so if you have an unlimited plan in the US, you get unlimited internationally as well. Unfortunately, data speeds are slowed after just 0.5 gigs of usage per day. So what does this mean? Data speeds go from being fast, like really fast, to borderline useless. Web browsing, no. Music streaming, no. Google Maps, no. Social media, no. And video watching, forget it. You can use it for light email use, iMessage, and other text-based messaging apps. And if you have Google Maps data pre-downloaded for tracking your location and getting directions. The good news is 0.5 gigs will be fine for most people, especially when you have Wi-Fi at coffee shops and your hotel. However, when you go over your 0.5 gig allotment, your patience will be tested, and many things will also stop working. Five travel passes are included for free with Verizon's Above Unlimited plan. Otherwise, you're paying $10 a day, and this adds up quickly. A 10-day trip like ours would add an additional $100 to your plan. So for longer trips, like a study abroad program, or if you're visiting relatives for a long period of time, Verizon thinks they have the answer: monthly international travel plans. Two options here: $70 a month for 100 minutes, 100 texts, and 0.5 gigs of data, or $130 for 250 minutes, 1,000 texts, and 2 gigs of data. Both plans allow you to receive unlimited incoming messages as well. So you may be looking at these low usage amounts and thinking, all right, are these like the day passes? Are they per day? You get half a gig, 100 minutes per day? Or are they per week? No, these are per month. So you'd get 100 minutes and half a gig for the entire month, and the cost is in addition to the Verizon plan you pay for in the United States. So Verizon, first of all, these are ridiculous. These are absolutely absurd. You're telling me you're giving me half a gig for 1 month? That's crazy low. People will blow through that in like a day, an afternoon. Second of all, you're gonna charge me $165 for this plan? That's absurd. Verizon, what the f— Moving on to Verizon's pay-as-you-go rates, their final option, and these are also ridiculously expensive, so don't even bother. All three of Verizon's international options are only available for postpaid plans, so I'm sorry, prepaid subscribers. And my take is this: if you're traveling abroad a lot, get the above unlimited plan, and enjoy the 5 free travel passes. If you need more data, consider getting the travel pass at $10 a day for up to like 3 days. Otherwise, things with Verizon just get expensive. If you need more data or if you're traveling abroad for a longer period of time, you're gonna seriously want to consider signing up for a local plan in the country you're visiting. Data rates are much cheaper, and we'll talk more about this towards the end of the video. Moving on to AT&T. AT&T has 3 similar options to Verizon: the AT&T International Day Pass, AT&T Passport, and pay-per-use rates. The Day Pass is $10 a day and lets you use your current postpaid plan internationally. If you're on an unlimited plan in the US, you'll be able to use unlimited minutes, unlimited texts, and unlimited high-speed data internationally as well. This is a huge advantage AT&T has over Verizon. Data speeds were fast for me. Personal hotspot and Wi-Fi calling also worked well when I was abroad. Note that calls made from international day pass countries to non-international day pass countries, links down below to check those out, will incur an international long distance charge. And this is an add-on in addition to the $10 a day for the day pass. The last caveat with AT&T is if more than 50% of your usage is international for 2 months in a row, then the international day pass feature will automatically be removed from your plan, which is not very friendly, AT&T. Thumbs down for that. The next option from AT&T is the AT&T Passport. AT&T has 2 plans here, and they are just as ridiculous as Verizon. Listen to this: $60 a month for 1 gig of data, $120 a month for 3 gigs of data, and you're charged 35 cents per minute for calls in addition to this. So calling isn't even included in those high prices. And if you go over your data allotment, AT&T will automatically add more data at $50 per gigabyte. This is outrageous. No, just no. Don't even, no, no. The final option with AT&T is their pay-per-use rates. And I don't know about you, but paying over $2,000 per gigabyte seems a little expensive to me. So like Verizon, these prices are astronomical and not even worth considering. It is important to note these rates are applied if you don't have an international package, when you're traveling in countries not included with a package, or when your package expires. So be really careful when traveling abroad with AT&T. You're gonna wanna take advantage of airplane mode or even consider just leaving your SIM card at home. Ultimately, I think the day passes are worth it for short trips, but everything else from AT&T is just overpriced. Sprint. Sprint has a different approach to international. They offer one add-on called Sprint Global Roaming. This is included for free with all of their unlimited plans. You can enjoy coverage in over 200 countries with calling at 25 cents per minute, free unlimited texting, and free unlimited data capped at 2G speeds. From my experience, these speeds are slow. And we're talking like barely usable slow. 0.1 megabits per second down and 0.1 megabits per second up. Okay for light email, iMessage, other chat apps, and tracking your location in Google Maps, but wow, will these speeds test your patience. For faster service, Sprint offers day passes and week passes. In Canada and Mexico, you can get fast speeds for $2 a day or $10 a week. In most other places, it's $5 a day or $25 a week. And in select few locations, it's $10 a day or $50 a week. Sprint outlines these locations quite well on their website, link down below to check this out. And I think these prices are very reasonable, especially when compared with Verizon and AT&T. Next up is T-Mobile, and with them, you're probably on the T-Mobile One plan. This plan includes 5 gigs of LTE in Canada and Mexico, and like Sprint, unlimited 2G in over 210 countries internationally. Keeping with the trend of Verizon and Sprint, however, T-Mobile's unlimited 2G data is unusably slow, except for iMessage, email, and tracking your location in Google Maps. So to fix this, T-Mobile has an onslaught of different options: T-Mobile One Plus, Global Plus 15 gigs, International One Day Pass, 5 gigs International Pass, and 15 gigs international pass. Let's take a moment to unpack what each of these means. T-Mobile One Plus is $15, and it's essentially the same as T-Mobile One. You get 2x the data speeds internationally and unlimited in-flight Wi-Fi on GoGo-enabled flights instead of just 1 hour. But again, I thought the speeds were already unusable, and 2x the speeds of unusable is still probably not very usable. I don't think it's worth it for the 15 bucks. Second option, Global Plus 15 gigs. This is $50 a month, but it's essentially signing up for an additional service plan while you're international. You get 15 gigs of LTE data in 210 countries, unlimited calling and messaging, 5 gigs of LTE for the hotspot data per month. This is ideal for longer trips or study abroad programs. The International One Day Pass is $5 a day, and it's exactly like Verizon's Travel Pass, except $5 a day instead of $10. You get half a gig of data, and you can use it for a 24-hour period. It includes mobile hotspot capabilities and unlimited calling to T-Mobile's 210-plus locations. Next is the 5-gig International Pass. $35 gets you 5 gigs of high-speed data, the mobile hotspot, and unlimited calling for 10 days in T-Mobile's 210-plus supported locations. It's a great option for slightly longer trips. The 15-gig International Pass is $50, lasts for 30 days, and gives you, of course, 15 gigs of data, mobile hotspot, and unlimited calling in the 210-plus supported locations. Again, this is great for longer trips, and it's essentially a one-time payment version of the Global Plus 15-gig option, as that is a monthly payment. So for T-Mobile, basically everything is worth it except their T-Mobile One Plus plan. It really just depends on your use case and how long you'll be traveling. You can see some of the options are great for shorter trips and some of the options are ideal for longer trips. The last carrier I decided to test out was Google Fi. Why? Because people on Reddit were recommending it to individuals looking to travel internationally, and Google announced support for iPhone, so more users are able to use their plan, and it could be worth considering. And it turns out the people on Reddit were right. The way Google Fi works is you pay $20 a month for service, and then $10 a month per gig of data. You can pay up to $80 a month, at which point the plan turns into an unlimited plan. And what's amazing about Google Fi and what makes it so great for traveling abroad is international coverage is included for free. Their rates remain the same. Not only that, but data speeds are fast. None of this unlimited 2G nonsense. You get the full high-speed data you expect while you're traveling abroad. I love it. You can see Google Fi's list of supported countries in the video description. And similar to Sprint, there are some international calling rates. So for calling, you will pay a little extra, but everything else is the same plan you'd expect from Fi, and you can even make and receive calls over Wi-Fi to expand your coverage area if for whatever reason you're in a super remote location and don't have service. Okay, after looking at all these carriers and plans and add-ons, how do they stack up? Looking at a 10-day trip, here's how they compare. Verizon and AT&T are the most expensive, and Google Fi is the clear winner in terms of price. However, I also really like the plans from T-Mobile. I think they do a great job with add-ons, accommodating people who are going on shorter trips and people who are going for longer trips or potentially staying for months at a time for a study abroad program. Now, with all that said, these plans are expensive, all of them. You're adding $35 to $100 per month in addition to the current plan you already have. Which brings us to our third option, signing up for service in the country you're visiting. What's amazing is cell phone plans are significantly more affordable in every other country besides the United States, and Canada, and Australia. Sorry to all of you Canadians and Australians out there, you've got it rough. But everywhere else, cell service is so much cheaper. Here are some example plans that I saw while I was traveling abroad. And the way it works is if, let's say you're using Verizon and you get a day pass, your phone is actually connecting to one of these networks that Verizon is partnering with. So instead of paying a high price through Verizon, you can get the same coverage and experience just signing up for the plan yourself. And as you can see, the rates are super cheap. You're paying anywhere from $20 to $40 to get everything you could possibly need for a quick 1 week trip or even a longer stay. So there you go. Those are the best cell phone plans for traveling internationally and how Verizon, AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, and Google Fi compare in terms of their international offerings. Ultimately, my preferred carriers are T-Mobile, Sprint, and Google Fi, as I think their offerings are the most affordable and the most reasonable to sign up for. And honestly, I think signing up for a carrier local to the country you're visiting is one of the best choices, as you'll get more data, faster speeds, at a significantly reduced price. Like this video if you found it helpful. Share it with anyone considering traveling abroad, studying abroad, or going on a trip. Subscribe for more videos like this one. I'm Stetson. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.